Hey everyone, we are going to talk about the GitHub sponsorship. Now let's look into what this GitHub sponsorship is all about. Who can sponsor and who is eligible to get sponsored? To be honest, anyone who has a GitHub account for like last 6 months and did any kind of open source contribution are eligible to apply for the GitHub sponsor. And the sponsorship is very straightforward. For example, I can see our sponsor button over here. So this button is only enabled when you apply for the sponsorship. So I will navigate you how you can apply for this particular sponsorship going forward. Now let's look at how it looks like, right? So now you can see there is like a sponsorship button in my profile. Now, if you really like my contribution, so this is how it works. For example, if you really like my contribution or there is one application which I'm developing for good cause, which is in like an open source project. Now, if you want to fund me, for example, any website requires a lot of amount to be spent on the domain, on the hosting. And if you are using any database on, for example, like MongoDB, so there will be like a lot of expenses coming around. So now the people around the globe, maybe it can be organization like Microsoft, Google, or it can be any of other open source contributor who are really willing to help on your project. They will ready to sponsor you some amount on a recurring basis or one-time installment. So how it happens is like, for example, if somebody else comes to my profile and they really like the projects which I'm contribute to and they want to support me, so what they can do is like they can click over here. Now here I can select maybe $10 monthly. So this will be like a recurring, so every month that you will be donating to Sanjay $10 each, or you can just make it like a one-time payment of $100 or $10, then select the payment, then it will redirect you into a particular page where you have to fill your billing information and your card details. So once you click on the save button, what happened is like you will be sponsoring me, right? Now let's look at how exactly this will happen in the profile. For example, when you start sponsoring someone, for example, I'm currently sponsoring this particular person. Now he's like a program manager of GSOC Extended. Now what happened is like you can even show in your profile that whether you are sponsoring someone or not. Now also the list of sponsoring button will be always available here. It's like a tab where you can see the particular person, for example, Sanjay has been sponsored in the past. So you can see a small amounts I've been contributing to all around the people. And here there will be like an explore sponsors button where you can see you can filter by ecosystem. For example, if you want to work on anything related to NPM, and you can filter by most sponsor, click on apply. So this will filter the most sponsored project on that particular domain. Now when you go here, you can see 242 people. That's crazy. 242 people are sponsoring this particular thing. This is something crazy. So right, so this is how it looks like. So I'm pretty much happy if anybody tried to sponsor me, or if you are looking for a sponsorship and you have a pretty much good profile, or if you have something amazing, then I would be really happy to sponsor you guys. All right, so that's how it works. And if you are sponsoring someone, that will be also show here. If somebody sponsor you, that can also show here along with the organization. So again, this is something comes with experience, and you can see this particular person is contributing to a lot of amazing apps over here. So that might be the reason that people are contributing. And yeah, it's been pretty long that this person has been started contributing. So, right. So make use of this sponsorship button in your profile. Now, let me show you how you can activate it. So in order to activate the sponsorship button, what you need to do is, let me go to my secondary account. You have your sponsor button over here. So what you need to do is you click over here. Now, right now you don't have a sponsor. Now it's asking you get sponsored button. Now it will ask you to enter your password. I hope I remember my password. All right. Yep. And now here you will have to select your country. For example, let me select India. Now you have to select your bank account and country where your bank account is located. Click on submit button. Now it will ask you to do some verification. So first thing is like you have to enable two-factor authentication to your account. And second one is like confirm your identity. So here you click on confirm your identity. It will ask you a lot of details like who you are, your personal information, something like that. So now you have to give this particular information, then your identity is confirmed. And second one is like two-factor authentication. So you have to add a passkey or you have to enable this two-factor authentication. So this is basically like you have to scan the QR code over here in your phone. And once you download this app, you will be able to get the verify code. Click on continue. That's how you verify your two-factor authentication. I'm not doing this particular procedure because it's very straightforward. Now, let me go back to over here. Now, once you do this particular identity verification and GitHub two-factor authentication, you will be able, you will be getting a confirmation mail in maybe I would say 1 week time. That would be the ideal time. So you will be able to see this option to publish your profile. So that's how it works. Maybe in the next video, I will show you how to publish your profile and how to make your profile stands out in terms of sponsorship. Now, there are a few more steps over here. Now, for example, let me go and search for GitHub sponsorship. All right. So we are in a page of GitHub sponsorship. So this is how it looks like. You know, you can hell lot of money from the people all around the globe if you have a good project. Right. Now it will ask you to set up your Stripe account when you apply for the sponsorship. So make sure that you do have your Stripe account with you. That's all they will be asking you once all the three activities completed. It is very straightforward procedure, like what to do. So I just fill my name and my billing address. Now you can see second option to enable the two-factor authentication. That's a very straightforward procedure. Now the last procedure is like create a Stripe account. Now when you click over here, what really happens is something like it will take you into this particular page of Stripe by GitHub sponsor. And it will ask you to verify your email ID. Now it will ask you a phone number to verify the phone number. Now, again, it's like a basic authentication over here. So it might ask you to verify your Stripe code. So let me verify that over here, 910748. So this would be your OTP, which you will be receiving in your phone. Now over here, so they mostly ask you again the same details like your bank account, where your account is located. So let me select India business. I would be skipping few of the steps because I don't want to activate any of this thing over here. All right. So I'm just giving us some random values over here. So on the next page, it will ask you your bank account details. So make sure that you give your bank account details over here, confirm your account number. That's it. So that's all it required. So once they will verify the bank account details, you will be able to see a green icon over here, which means that okay, your account is ready to get published. And also they will be sending you a mail on okay, your account is active. Now you can publish your sponsor button on your GitHub page. So that's a very straightforward procedure. Now there might be some scenarios where some issues is happening and it's getting delayed and you're not getting back from any information from the GitHub team. So in that case, what I would suggest you is In that case, what I would suggest you is go to this particular page, support.github.request. I would be sending this link in the description. Now go to over here, select the respective issue. For example, if it is related to your account, select it over here and select which one it is related to. GitHub sponsor, write a subject and write a details like, okay, you have been applied for the GitHub sponsor, but you haven't heard from them back. So once you drop it, within 2 or 3 days, they will be looking into your account and approving it based on further verification. So that's how it works. And you can also go and explore this particular page on respective support forums available. All right, so that's how things works over here. So I would recommend only this would really help in terms of getting the support from the GitHub. So make sure that you apply for the support ticket if you are not getting heard back from the GitHub team in like 1 or 2 weeks. So yeah, I hope everyone's sponsor button will get approved. Once you get approved, just try to follow me back on the GitHub or share your amazing repository with me directly on my LinkedIn or something. If I really like it, I would definitely sponsor you. All right, so that's all from my side, and see you in the next video on how to activate your sponsor profile and how to optimize it. Thank you for listening to me. Bye.